Okay, nobody asked, but I'm giving it to you anyway. The question is, who is the greatest dog trainer of all time? Who is the GOAT? This is subjective. This is obviously my opinion, but my opinion is correct. The problem is we can't go off of championships like athletes. We can't go off Academy Awards like actors. But there's some criteria, it's important criteria. So greatest of all time dog trainer. So here's the list. Cesar Millan, he's gotta be on the list. If you have a TV show, you made the list. Four of these people have had TV shows. You make the list. It's hard to get a TV show. We know who Cesar Millan is. Gary Brooks, you might not know who he is. He is the smartest dog trainer on this list by far. He started, along with Karen Pryor, started the sort of modern dog training movement like 40 years ago. I don't know how long. Super smart guy, nice guy, I like him very much. Karen Pryor, she wrote Don't Shoot the Dog, which is the positive reinforcement dog trainer's Bible, okay? I've read it, I had to read it in school. She's been doing this a long time. Now she has a clicker training academy that all the positive reinforcement trainers basically have to go to be anything. Although, dog training is not about clicker training and it is not about all positive reinforcement, but she's gotta be on the list. She's been doing it a long time. Zach George, over 2 million YouTube subscribers. You're making the list if you've got that many. Victoria Stillwell, she had a TV show, so she makes the list. Joel Silverman, near and dear to my heart, he was a former killer whale trainer like me. Nice guy, commented on one of my posts. I've kind of followed him for many years. Wrote a book, right? Good stuff, good stuff. Jass, I don't know how to say his last name. Netflix show, he's a good trainer, and you get a TV show, you make this list. Emily Laurelham, she has Kiko Pup on YouTube. One of the best shapers of behavior I've ever seen. Shaping is training through approximations using positive reinforcement. Dolphin trainers, killer whale trainers are the best at that in the entire animal industry. And she is right up there, does amazing things with her own dogs. Unfortunately, it's mainly just her own dogs. So she ain't gonna last long, but good trainer. Okay, and then yours truly, Joel Beckman. You guys have said in the comments that I'm a goat, so I'm gonna put myself on the list. All right, now we're gonna eliminate people. So here's the deal. If you don't work with aggressive dogs, you are not the GOAT. Not even close. You can't be the greatest of all time and not work with a giant chunk of the dog training industry, and the part that really needs help, the people that really need help are people with aggressive dogs. If you don't do that, you almost can't even call yourself a dog trainer, to be honest with you. You're not doing the deal. Not to say they're not great trainers, but you can't be on this list if you don't work with aggressive dogs. Who's off the list? Karen Pryor's off the list. I've never seen her work with an aggressive dog. If you can find me the video of Karen Pryor not talking about aggression, working with aggression, fixing aggression, she'll be back on the list. Till then, she's off the list. Zach George, I don't really see, I've watched a little bit of his channel, I don't see aggression. I see some reactivity, I see hyperactivity, I don't see aggression, so he's off the list. Nice guy though, nice guy. I did a video talking about why I liked him and he commented. Just seems like a really nice guy. Victoria Stillwell, she has some reactivity on her YouTube and her TV show, so she's gonna stay. Joel Silverman, as much as I like the guy, I know he's worked with aggressive dogs. I assume he has worked with aggressive dogs. I've never seen it. He had an Animal Planet show. I just haven't seen it. So until I see it, he's gotta be off the list. Although, awesome trainer. He wrote a book about how to deal with like a hyper dog compared to a calm dog. It's like, what color is your dog? I think I bought it. I don't think I read the whole thing, but what I did read, it was a good book. He works with aggressive dogs. This guy's a good trainer. This Netflix guy, Jess. Good trainer, so he's on the list. Emily Laurelham, never seen her work with an aggressive dog. Talking about aggression is not working with aggression. She may talk about it until someone can provide me the video. She's off the list. All right, so that leaves five of us. Cesar, Gary, Victoria, Jas, and myself. Now it's longevity. The greatest of anything has got to have a long career. It's one of the criterias for greatness. This guy, Jas, he looks pretty young. Good trainer, maybe great trainer. He's younger than me, I know that. So he's off the list. Me, I've been doing this, owned my business for 14 years, 3 years killer whale training, 2 years exotic animal training, lions, monkeys, birds. What is that, 17, 18 years? That's a good chunk of change, so I'm gonna keep myself on the list. All right, now it's down to these four, final four. This is my own channel. I cannot call myself the greatest of all time. I'm going to take myself off. And I haven't been doing it a long time. I haven't been doing it as long as these two guys. Maybe as long as her, I don't know. But I'm taking myself off the list. Now, Victoria, Gary, Cesar Millan. She is not in this category. She's just not. Not enough aggression. Not enough aggression. Not enough reactivity. Too many edits in her show to where we don't see the whole process. You gotta show the whole process. You gotta show your work, as one of my commenters said. She's off the list. Now it comes to Cesar and Gary. Gary Wilkes, smartest guy on the list. They have come after. The purely positive folks have come after these two guys. Tried to destroy them. This guy has never backed down. Never once. And that is so admirable. Okay? However, I don't know if he changed the game. He doesn't have the reach that Cesar Millan has. Okay? Cesar Millan has a giant reach and just completely changed the game like nobody's business. So Gary is off, as great as he is. Cesar is the GOAT. There is no doubt about it. He's done it for a long time. The free market has spoken. Cesar Millan, he didn't dupe a bunch of people with his TV show. He didn't dupe a bunch of clients. Nobody can be duped that much. He did the deal. He showed his work on his show. He even put, I remember years ago, that he was being accused of editing too much. So he put a clock in the corner of the show saying, I'm doing this in real time. Okay? He is the GOAT. He is the best. There is no doubt about that. Maybe one of these other people will be one day, but until that, he's the best. Changed the game, tons of aggression. That's the hard stuff. That's my list. It is set in stone. I have thought about it. If you have someone different, please comment. Let me know. I'll look at it. But until then, he's the man. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. That's it.